Welcome back to the program. My name is Rose Okinda. We are joined by Esther Nguku, a motivational speaker. She's a counselor, a businesswoman. She's also a minister of the gospel, married to another minister of the gospel. We're glad you're with us. Karibu sana.
Excellent.
Before we went on a break, we were talking about the church. And I said when we come back, we also want to look about, we want to look at your family life. You're married.
Yeah.
So the obvious question will be, do you have children?
At the moment, I'm still waiting upon God, mm-hmm. and I have no doubt about it.
Okay.
He promised he's going to fulfill.
How many years of waiting?
I have been waiting on God for more than 13 years,
mm-hmm.
and I have not given up because I know he's faithful to his word.
Mm-hmm.
And I will never be put to shame.
Okay. Mm. It cannot be easy, because I know you say it so easily, but maybe because you're so grounded in your faith, that's why you can speak about this with ease. But I want you to talk to women who have been waiting, you know, 5 years plus, 10 years plus, and they're feeling like God has forgotten them. And they're crying about it. Their families, even as we speak right now, which are breaking up
mm-hmm.
because of a lack of children.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's just not about the husband and wife that's the problem. But sometimes it's outside pressure. It's about his relatives, probably about your relatives and people, pressure from without as opposed to pressure from within. Let's talk about that.
Rose, I can assure you it is not easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, sometimes you cry out, there is no one to comfort you. You just cry out, you ask yourself many questions. You just evaluate your life, where did I go wrong? You look for many things, maybe to justify that.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, just trust in the Lord. He's going to be with you. Yes, people are going to talk.
Mm-hmm.
Even as the minister of the gospel, you'll hear people say, first pray for yourself, then we can trust for you.
Mm-hmm.
How come unaomba Mungu atende na bado hajakutendea? Yeah, sometimes also you go and pose such question to God. God, it is not about me, but it's all about you.
Mm-hmm.
How am I going to tell them that you normally do it if you don't do it for me?
Mm-hmm.
And that one does not even move God. Unaona kana kwamba haziki.
Right.
But the thing is, he's waiting for the right time
mm-hmm.
so that he can do it.
Right.
I have met with women in my church.
Mm-hmm.
Wamekuja wamelia hawana watoto. We have to encourage them to wait upon God.
Mm-hmm.
Wengine ni miaka miwili wanaona ni kana kwamba it is a century. Unasema wanasikia wanasema the in-laws. It is not about the in-laws.
Mm-hmm.
The issues of children, it is not about in-law.
Mm-hmm.
It is about you and your husband.
Mm-hmm.
So you should close your ears.
Mm-hmm.
Let a woman close your ears. Let a husband close your ears. It is you and your wife. Kama ulimpenda, watoto ni baraka.
Mm-hmm.
Na haiwezi ukajibariki.
Mm-hmm.
You'll have to wait on the one who blesses
right.
to bless you with the children.
Mm-hmm.
And when you wait upon him, he's not going to discourage you.
Mm-hmm.
I remember some times back, about years ago,
mm-hmm.
during Tuesday's meeting, I happened to be in the church. And there, and I met a couple.
Mm-hmm.
It is not kawaido pate couples wawili walking together.
Right.
And I remember the pastor ministered to them and requested them to come. Ni waombe. Kusema kweli, because I know what it feels. Because let me tell you the truth. There was a time. Ilifika wakati nikaona wenye wanaoleka nyuma yangu wanapata watoto. Sina watoto. I was so discouraged. And inside me, I developed a negative attitude.
Right.
Na nikasema, I'll never talk to these women. I'll never touch those children.
You became bitter.
I was very bitter, to be honest.
Mm.
But I remember one day, nikajipata tu neno linanihubilia inside me. And I told God, I have to overcome this. And how am I going to overcome this? Nitakuwa ninawaombea. During their period of pregnancy, during delivery.
Yes.
During delivery, I will visit them in maternity
mm-hmm.
and give present to the children.
Right.
And by so doing, mm-hmm. I overcame that.
Mm.
I'm in peace.
Right.
I'm in total peace about
yes.
that. So when I saw this couple come to me, and nikawauliza, Pastor mewambia niwaombe nini? It was normal. Wengine alikuwa nakuja, I would pray as the Spirit of God would lead me.
Mm-hmm.
When they come, both of them, and I wondered, what about this?
Right.
And wakaniambia, tunataka Mungu atupatia mtoto.
Mm.
I hugged them and I cried before God. And the burden was too heavy in my heart.
Right.
Back I had to tell the intercessors, we have to go to the prayer mountain.
Mm.
I have an issue. It was not about me, but it's about them.
Okay.
Nikawambia, they are very young.
Mm.
And I don't see the reason why this marriage should break.
Okay.
Let us trust God.
Okay.
For sure, we cried to God.
Mm-hmm.
Today, they have a baby
okay.
by the name Joel.
And how long did it take you to come to this place where you're saying, I choose not to be bitter? Because it took a while. for you to come to this place. Mm-hmm. You were bitter for a long while, and I appreciate you and applaud you for your raw honesty to come to a place where you're saying, now God, I am turning the tables around, and I am no longer going to be bitter, because mm-hmm. this is all the enemy wants me to do, but I am going to pray for this pregnant young woman who are coming to me and getting children before me. How long did it take before you came to this place?
It was some months, because okay. I did not want it to take roots. Uh-huh. Because there was a time, I told you I was a Sunday school teacher.
Yes.
There are some times, but I'm still in marriage. Wa mama wanabeba, wanaoreka, wanabeba mimba. In 3 times, wananiletea mtoto. Kwa Sunday school, I used to believe, kama anaweza ongea, he has to say something.
Yes.
So these small children, ungewambia, waseme kitu. Sasa wakati, sometimes I remember one Sunday morning, I attended the class, I was late.
Yeah.
Nikapata wale wakubwa, wame organize the whole Sunday school, everything was moving, kama kawaida. Mm-hmm. And by so doing, nikaona wana invite, wenye wamebebwa mimba, well, I'm still a Sunday school teacher, and I'm still in marriage. Mm. They are the one who's standing, saying, Bwana asifiwe, I'm so and so, and I'm born again. I cried. So wakati this root ilianza kutaka, ilianza kumea inside me. Si kutaka it take root. Mm-hmm. So I had to be very fast and uproot it. Okay. Because I know I will gain nothing out of that bitterness. Mm-hmm. What I'm going to do, I'll be negative.
Okay.
So I had to fight with this vice of negativity.
All right.
So I did not let it take roots mm-hmm. inside me.
Okay. It's interesting that you're saying that and you went through that. Because people go a lot of things. Some people, I had a woman come to my show and she shared and said, you know, sometimes Rose, you're thinking you're married and you're thinking your problem is children.
Mm-hmm.
But there's someone who's not married and she's thinking, God, I just want to be married. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes there's someone who has children and is saying, I think the single person is much better than me
mm-hmm.
because maybe I am single, I have children, I have no husband. And somebody else has a husband and they're blessed with a husband, but they're thinking, Lord, probably I like the one who's single and has children. It is about, like you said, probably it's just about waiting on God and waiting for the perfect timing. If you were to address a single woman right now and she's thinking this is her life and she's probably envious of people who are in marriages, what would you say?
I will still encourage them, wait on the Lord,
right.
Especially mm-hmm. those who are in the house of God.
Mm-hmm.
Don't move from here to there. Don't look for husband for yourself.
Right.
Because by so doing, you'll also find a man who is looking for a wife,
mm-hmm.
who is not straightforward. Chake tu kenye nataka is just a wife. And once you get in the house, it's going to turn to be another person.
Mm-hmm.
So even if you're single, it doesn't matter how long it is going to take you. Just wait on God.
Right.
You are not all that old. Maybe you're 40, have witnessed women getting married at an age of 40. Si eti kwamba utasema at the 40 naenda kufanya nini kwa ndoa, we not enjoy marriage.
Mm-hmm.
Marriage is there to be enjoyed mm-hmm. even at the old age.
All right.
So don't be on a hurry. Mm-hmm. Wait upon God.
Okay.
I remember a sister who was close to me. She was very active in the house of God. Miaka ikaenda wasichana nalea wakioreka. They even gave her a name to mock her.
Mm-hmm.
But she was still waiting on God.
Okay.
And one day, a day came for her.
Okay.
The day that was very bright,
mm-hmm.
God aliacha tu ipambazuke kwake. Today she is married to a man who is God-fearing,
mm-hmm.
and they are having a very happy marriage
okay.
together.
Okay.
So singles, do not be on a hurry.
Okay.
Wait upon God. Let them talk.
Okay.
Let them say whatever they want to say. As long as you know your relationship with your God,
yes.
He's going to summon somebody from somewhere.
Okay.
Just wait on God. Don't be on a hurry.
Mm.
Haijalishi uko na mtoto amefikisha teenage, hata karibu aoreke.
Mm.
Hata kama ni doa ya mtoto yako ipange, lakini just wait on God.
Right.
He's going to come for you.
Okay.
He's not on a hurry.
All right.
He's preparing the best person for you.
Okay.
Maybe he's fashioning him wherever he is.
Okay.
Just wait.
All right. I want to talk about your church leadership and basically how it looks like. Because leadership styles are very different in many churches.
Mm-hmm.
And for those who come to your church to worship with you, what is the leadership like in your church?
When it comes to leadership,
mm-hmm.
this task is too heavy.
Right.
You have to have different groups,
mm-hmm.
but they are all answerable to one person.
Mm-hmm.
If it is the youth, they have the youth leader who is answerable to the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
They have a patron who is watching
mm-hmm.
whatever they are doing.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to women, we also have the women in leadership.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the charidens and whatever they are learning, their group as a woman. But that is, they are also answerable to the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to the Sunday school, the same. When it comes to the men, the same. We are all answerable to the pastor.
Mm-hmm.
But the thing is, when it comes to this leadership, we are all equal before the eyes of the Lord. Mm-hmm. And we are all working toward one God, mm-hmm. just to serve the Lord mm-hmm. the way he wants us to serve him.
Okay.
So when it comes maybe to leadership, yeah, sometimes you'll have to invite maybe ministers of the gospel who are going to come and talk about your leadership. Because Rose, when it comes to leadership, you will see kuna watu watawekwa in leadership and anaona his overall. Mm-hmm. But we also remind the people that you have to be submissive to the person who is in authority okay. over you.
All right. Disputes. How do you handle disputes? Because sometimes churches do split because of disputes. Mm-hmm. We're unable to handle them, or there's certain disputes that people cannot agree on. Because at the end of the day, we are human beings. And like any other place, whether it be ministry, whether it be in business, disputes will always arise. How do you handle disputes?
Rosie, when it comes to leadership or any matter related to that,
okay.
you have all to work together. Mm. And you have to tell the people, this is our vision. We are working toward this.
Okay.
You are all working toward the same goal. Mm. So when there are some disputes, you have to sit down, you discuss about it. You discuss about it, you see the way forward. But you cannot just let it be. So lazima mukae pamoja muonge, are we heading to where we were heading? Because mm-hmm. ulipokuja tulikwambia this is where we are heading. Mm-hmm. Are we still sailing in the same boat?
Okay.
Ama kuna mwenye anataka kushuka.
Okay.
So you have to discuss those things.
Okay.
Yeah.
I want to also talk about if people wanted to come and worship with you and they wanted to come and share with you how they can find you. But towards the end, I'm going to come back to that question. What I want to talk about is if you describe the journey, your journey, the ministry, the church that you have planted, how has it been since you started to now, and how have you seen that growth progressed even as you have believed in God?
Oh, when it comes to church, God has commissioned us to go and make people his disciples. So kama ni Mungu amekuita, he's going to see you through. Mm-hmm. The Bible says that the steps of a righteous man are being commanded by God. So you have to be connected, you have to get counsel from God. Mm-hmm. So when we started this church, or when God sent us to Eldoret to come and work for him here, we did not know where to start. In fact, tulianzia mahali kwa krab. Kutoka kwa krab akatupatia mahali kulikuwa na nyumba tu kidogo. Then we were still praying to God. We are preaching, people are increasing, the praise became too small for us. Na tukamuliza God, from here God, where are we going to head to?
Right.
So tukaanza kutafuta proti. He promised us along the highway, nitawapatia mahali whereby you are going to worship me. True to his word, baada ya kutafuta, he led us, he connected us with the people. Mpaka tukapata mahala ambapo tuna worship.
Okay.
Tukianzia mpaka kujenga the church, Rose. To us, it's all about God. Because tukianzia, we'd not even have the money to start. But I thank God because of my pastor, who is my husband. He would only say a word, as the Bible says in the book of Daniel, ya kwamba we are going to speak a word and God is going to fulfill it. Kwa hivyo alikuwa anasema tu coming Sunday we are going to worship at a praise that is going to be like this and this.
Yes.
And God would intervene. Angekuja tu to fulfill his word.
Right.
Mpaka kanisa ikajengeka na ikafika mahala ambapo imefika. Kama ni kununua vyombo, anasema I need this. Anasema tu neno, anatamuka tu neno. Rose, the Bible, God calls us, we are small gods. In the book of Matthew, in the book of Psalms, anasema, did I not say that you are gods? What about God? Is Jehovah Elohim? Yeah, alikuwa anasema, let there be, na kitu kinakuja kuwa. So even today, if we believe less Christians, because we are working for this God, and we are co-workers with him, so he's working inside us. So tukisema two things, yeah, atakuja kuifulfill. He says, I'm going to summon the birds of the air and a man from a far off country to fulfill my purpose.
Okay.
Kwa hivyo, if you are a minister of the gospel, it is God who have called you. Don't worry about this job
or
this ministry. Maana hii ni kazi ametuitia. That's why nasema job. Maana ni kazi ametuitia tufanye pamoja na yeye.
Right.
Atakuja kuiendelesha na atakuja kuitamatisha.
Okay.
He makes a way where there is no way.
Okay. Very well said. As we finish, I have noticed that we have not even said the name of the church itself. So today I want you to just address this other camera and speak to the viewer. What is the name of the church? Where can you be found when they want to come and share with you, or they just want to visit by and share with you as well?
As we had noted when we were starting the program, I am a minister of the gospel, married to the minister of the gospel. We preach Christ in a ministry called Merrick Zedek Gospel Fire Ministry. We are located in Eldoret, in Langas Estate, It is along Kisumu Eldoret Highway on your way to airport. If you would like to come and worship with us, utapanda gari za kwenda kona, kuna gari za Langas Kisumu Dogo, sasa utachukua gari za Langas kona mbaya. Utashuka junction ya kwenda kona mbaya. Alafu upande ukielekea side ya airport about 30 meters from kona mbaya junction. Utapata kanisa inaitwa Merrick Zedek. Kwa hivyo nakuarika kuja tuabudu Mungu pamoja na sisi. Come, let us exalt the Lord together because he's so faithful. Wacha kukaa nyumbani kama uko wrong hapa Eldoret, uko Rangers, huendangi kanisa. Come, because the Bible says faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. So by hearing the word of God, it is this word that is going to change you because it has power. The Bible says the word of God is living and active. So it is the word that is going to transform you because the word, it is Christ himself.
Okay. Hallelujah. Thank you so much for coming to the show. And thank you so much for sharing your story with us and for being very honest with me. And I hope we can be able to meet on another platform and share on other matters as well. Well, there you have it. My name is Rose Okinda and I want to thank you so much for your company. Until next week, where we'll be doing this all over again, it's goodbye from all of us here.